The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, text number 19, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on September 29th, 1974, in Mayapur, India.
Maya Jamanika Achanyam. अज्ञा अधोखजम अव्ययम न लक्षसे मुददिशा नटो नाट धरो यथा सो वन साइड इज माया जवनिका छन्नम माया दिस इल्यूसरी एनर्जी इज कवरिंग with the carpet. Just like we are seeing the deity, but if there is a curtain, we cannot see. Similarly, there is a curtain which is illusory energy, maya. The big scientists, they cannot see what is behind this material nature. They cannot understand. Because the maya, this wonderful material energy, is acting in such a big curtain, they cannot understand that beyond this there is something else. They cannot understand. Maya javunika achannam illusory energy. They are thinking this material energy working, that is everything. Nothing beyond this. The whole world is covered. This is one side. And the other side, agnya, माया जब जमुनिका छन्नम अज्ञा दीज मेटीरियलिस्टिक पर्सन्स दे आर अज्ञा मैन दे हैव नो सफिशियंट नॉलेज अनलेस वन डेवलप्स द लाइट ऑफ नॉलेज सतगुण Satogun is the light of knowledge. Rajogun and Tamogun is darkness. Ignorance and passion. In this stage, one cannot understand what is Krishna, what is Lord. Agya. Rajastama bhava. As you have discussed in Bhagavad, Srimad Bhagavatam, Rajastama Bhava, those who are infected with the two kinds of material modes, means Rajagun and Tamagun, they are simply busy, Kama and Lobha. They are busy only those who are passionate, they are simply busy for sense gratification, and those who are in ignorance, in darkness, they have no eyes to see. So these two classes of men, mostly people are infected with these two kinds of modes of material nature. Rajastam, the whole world. At the present moment especially, mostly ignorance, and some of them are passionate. That passionate tendency is engaging them for so many industries and very strong work, ugrakon. Ugra karma. Ugra karma means very strong, what this should be, the English word, ugra. Ugra, just like chili, pungent. There are many things. They are very strong in taste. So ugra karma, these, just like they are building 150 stories building. People can live comfortably in a small cottage or one-storied house or little more, but no, they're increasing. Their passionate activities are increasing. Just like in your country, in New York, now there is 104-storied building or more than that. Some building, 110. Two of them, they are increasing. They are thinking by increasing the stories more and more, that is advancement of civil. That how long you will increase? If you make a million stories, still it is unlimited. That we can see. So many aeroplanes are running in the sky. What is that? Still, it is vast. So many Sputniks are running in the sky. Still, it is vast. So it is simply desire that if I make a 150-storied house, then my life is successful. So in this way, instead of not wasting valuable time of this human life, they are simply wasting time in this way. That is also explained in the Ramana, just the Ravana. He wanted to make a staircase up to the heavenly planet. It is like that. Ugra karma. Oh, why they are doing so? Ajna. Ajna. Foolish people. Now if we say that you are all foolish, rascal people, you are wasting your time in this way, they will think us crazy, and they think us like that, that we do not recommend these things. So, it is very, very difficult to understand Krishna in this condition, in this situation. Maya javanika achannam and ajna. Foolish people. Ajna. And the other side, Krishna is adho khaja. Even one is advanced in knowledge. Knowledge means, our knowledge means, we manufacture words or syllables from A to Z, that's all. A, B, C, D. We compose words with these 26, or how many? A to Z? Yes. That is, and in Sanskrit, as in English, it is A to Z. Similarly, in Sanskrit, O, I, E, U, and the end is Ksha. So, O and Ksha, that is called Aksha. Akshaja. And Ja means generated. So, we also compose words, those are Sanskrit scholars. They compose words from O to Aksha. Just like English, they compose words from A to Z. So our mental speculation and advancement of education is limited between these O and Aksha. Aksha. Akshaja. But Krishna is Adhokshaja. Adhokshaja means where these kinds of speculation beginning from Atuksha will not act. Therefore his name is Adhokshaja. Adhokrita. Curved down. Why they are going? They are busy in some other work. Ugra karma. Without hearing what he'll do, nonsense. Savanam kirtanam. This is our main business. Savanam. If you don't hear, what he'll do? He'll do simply sense gratification. That's all. So this is difficulty. That we are not very much interested in hearing. And that is the main business. Our bhakti begins, Savanam kirtanam Vishnu. We have to hear. And we have to speak. But if we are not interested in hearing speak, then it will be the same Thakur Bari. Simply formula, that's all. And gradually it will be stopped. Unless there is life of Sravanam Kirtanam, these big building temples will become burden. See, if we want to create burden for future, then we may give up this hearing and chanting and sleep very nicely. It will be burden. Galagraha. Not Sivigraha, but Galagraha. Galagraha. Sivigraha means worshipable deity. See, if we give up this Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu, then it will be thought that our Guru Maharaj has given a burden in the neck. Galagraha. This is the danger. So, we must be very much alert in Savanam Kirtanam. Otherwise, all this labor will be futile. This building will be only the nest for the doves and the pigeons. That is the danger. That is being done. Nobody is interested. Such things. Now, who can understand Krishna? There are so many impediments. One side, there is curtain of Maya. Another side, everyone is rascal and fool. And another side, Krishna is beyond your sense perception. This is the position. How much one must be alert? Then one can understand, just like the Goswami. This Krishna is so easy thing to understand, but there is process. So if we do not adopt the process, then how we can understand Krishna? These are the so many difficult things. One thing is the Maya is checking. Maya is trying to put stumbling block for your advancement of spiritual life. Maya javanika chandam. And the other side, we are all fools and rascals. And again, Krishna is adhokhaja, beyond the range of sense perception. This is the position. See, unless we become very serious to understand Krishna, it is very, very difficult to understand Krishna. Maya javanika chandam. One side, Kunti said, antadvahi avasthitam Krishna, you are within Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe. Krishna is not far away. Krishna is always with you. He is so friendly that just like two birds, it is said in the Upanishad, one bird is eating the fruit of the tree, another bird is simply guiding and seeing. Because this material world, living entity, wanted to enjoy. Just like you have seen that the dog and the master. The master is so friendly to the dog out of love. It is a dog. But when it is passing stool, he is waiting. Why? Is the duty of the master to wait because the dog is passing stool? No, out of love. Out of love. We can see from practical example. Similarly, the master may be a great millionaire, but still he loves the dog so much that in the morning walk he takes his dog and the dog is passing urine. What business dog has got to pass urine and stool and go this way and that way? But the master is attending. Similarly, God or Krishna is so affectionate that we have come here in this material world simply to pass stool and urine. Still he is attending. Still he is attending. Just imagine what merciful is Krishna. In the Upanishad says the two birds, the one bird is Paramatma. Krishna has become Paramatma. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita that khetra khetragya. There are two things. One is this khetra, this body. Khetra, that's the field. It's like you are tilling the field. And the tiller, the Krishan. Similarly, we have got this field. And we are growing our own, harvesting our own grains. Just like you are doing. So according to our labor, according to our attempt, we are getting food grains. Similarly, we have got this body, and I am, the spirit soul is the tiller. So according to my karma, I am getting the result. So, similarly, not only I am there, but Krishna is also there. He is seeing what you are doing. What are doing, what you want more. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishta, Krishna says. I am sitting in everyone's heart. Why? Just to give him the facilities. This rascal, living being, has come to this material world to till the field to get some result. All right, let him do that. Just like children play on the beach, do all nonsense, and the father sits. All right, you have finished your business, come on. So Krishna is like that. He is simply saying, we are acting so nonsensically, and Krishna is giving us the same way. The dog passing stool and urine, the master is acting. Or the father is saying, the children are playing on the beach, they are making big, big house on the sand, and it has nothing, no value, but Krishna, the father, is giving the opportunity. All right, do it. So Krishna is giving us all the facilities, but we are so poor that we cannot understand that Krishna is so friendly. That is, it is said, na lakshasi muladisha. They cannot see because mura disha. Mura means rascal and drisha. Drisha means seeing. They have no power to see. A mura cannot see. Rascals, they cannot see. They are very much proud. Can you show me God? But they do not think whether I am qualified to see. They are very much proud of this eye. So what is the value of this eye? Therefore Krishna says, yes, you can see me, but according to my direction. You see me, rasoham of sukhantriya. You can see, it is very easy for you. You see me in the water. While you taste, while you drink water, you see me. I am the taste. So, everyone drinks water, and he gets some test, otherwise why is drinking water? So that test, if you remember, that here is Krishna. Simply by tasting water, simply by drinking water. If you follow Krishna's instruction, one day will be devotee. Krishna is so kind. Simply by drinking water. Simply we have to know how to see Krishna. Therefore Kunti Devi says, na lakshasi murhadisa. The murha, the rascal, is so foolish. Krishna says that you see me in the taste of water, but this rascal, this is Hamma. This is Hamma. How in the taste Krishna is there? I want to see in my own eyes. But you haven't got that eyes. Just develop your eyes gradually. Just like one is suffering from some eye disease. So, take some medicine. Then gradually your eyesight will be improved. Take the spectacle, some power, then more power, more power. But they will not take the instruction of Krishna, the instruction of spiritual master, so they want to remain muradrisha, rascal and fool. Still they want to see Krishna. This is the difficulty. Na lakshasi muradrisha. If you do not improve your eyes according to the direction of Shastra, Sadhu, Shastra, Guru, these three things, then how will you see Krishna? Krishna is saying that is Shastra. Shastra means what is said by the Supreme Personality of God. That is Shastra. And Guru, Guru says the same thing. And Sadhu says the same thing. Sadhu, Guru, test means they do not change the words of Krishna. They do not say, now I have manufactured something. Krishna says that you can see me in the taste of water. I can say that you can see in this way. You see me and you will see Krishna. That's the Mayavadi says. You think of me. In the Aurobindo ashram, they have no other business. The disciples are advised that whatever you like you can do, you should always think of Aurobindo. Just like Krishna says, manmana bhava mad bhakta madhyani mang namaskuru. I inquired from the inmates of the Aurobindo ashram. So I mean, what do you do? That we think of Aurobindo. Because Aurobindo thinks that he is Krishna. As Krishna says, manmana bhava mad bhakta. So they advise that you think of me. So the inmates, they think and smoke bidi and cigarette, that's all. I've seen it. So these things are going on. Murodisha. If we want to remain Murodisha, then it will be difficult for us to see Krishna. We have dedicated our life to see Krishna, to talk with Krishna, to play with Krishna, to have Krishna as our son, to have Krishna as our friend, Krishna as our lover. If this is our ambition, then we should not remain Murodisha. Foolishly. So we have to follow the Mahajana Jinagada. That's Kunti's advice. Kunti is, she knows how to see Krishna. She knows here is Krishna, although he is playing the part of my brother's son, nephew, but actually he is the Supreme Personality of God. Just like Arjun, he was talking like friend, but when he saw that it is impossible to solve this problem, I am inclined not to fight and kill my relatives, but the duty is to kill them. It is a very perplexed position. So therefore, he accepted Krishna as Guru. He said that I do not find anyone else who can solve my this problem. Therefore, Krishna, I am surrendering unto you. Shishasti ham sadhiman kripanna. Now we are not talking as friend. I accept you as Guru. When one accepts somebody as Guru, he cannot argue. That is the condition. Panipate na sampurna. fully surrender. Otherwise, there is no meaning of making a guru. It is not like that. A pet, a dog, that everyone makes guru and let me have a guru. But that is not the guru means, first of all, the condition is pranipa, fully surrender. Not that if I like, then I shall carry your order. And if I don't like, then I shall not do it. That is not acceptance of guru. Pranipa, first of all, we must agree. So, because friends and friends talking, a friend may agree with his friend, he may not agree. That is friendly talk. But Arjuna became Shishyastyam. I am now your Shishya, disciple. Now there is no question of disagreeing with him. Whatever he will say, I will accept. So at last, Krishna said, surrender unto me. And Arjuna did it. That is the whole purpose of Bhagavad Gita. He changed his decision. He changed. He did not want to fight. That was his decision. But when he accepted Krishna as guru, and he said that he must fight, it is my desire. Even you don't fight, these people are not going back home. They will be killed here. That is my already plan. So these things are discussed in the Bhagavad Gita. So if we remain mudhadrisha, in spite of opening our eyes in so many ways, by Krishna, by Guru, by Shastra, still, if we remain mudhadrisha, then how we can see Krishna? That is not possible. Therefore it is said, na lakshasi mudhadrisha. If we keep our eyes still, mudha, illusion, then we cannot see how nato nato dharo jatha. Exactly, Krishna, just like one of my relatives, he is playing before me. But because I am mudhadrisha, my eyesight or my intelligence is not correct. I am seeing that somebody else. I see that my relative, my brother or father or friend is dancing on the stage, but he is dressed in such a way that in spite of being present in my front, I cannot recognize. So if we remain mudhadrisha, then we cannot see Krishna. Otherwise, Krishna is everywhere. Akhilatma bhuta. In the Brahma Sangita it is said, Goloka eva nivasati akhilatma bhuta. Although he is living in Goloka Vrindavan, he is everywhere. Then how can I see? Premanyana churita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva ridayesu vilok. Those who have developed love for Krishna, they can see always 24 hours Krishna, nothing but Krishna. This is the process. So, we have to increase our attachment, our love for Krishna. Maya sattamana pratha jugam junjana madasra. This is also explained. Everything is there. Mayasakta. We have to increase our attachment for Krishna, our love of Krishna. Then we shall see Krishna always. Premanyana chrita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva rida jang shyama sundaram achinta gunas sarupam govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajam. These are the practical experience of Mahajan, Brahma. The Brahma Sangata is written by Brahma. He is Mahajan. Mahajan means the person who knows Krishna. The Mahajans are described in the 12 Mahajans. Narada Sambhu Sambhu. Narada is Mahajan. And Brahma is Mahajan, Sambhu. And Lord Shiva is Mahajan. Kapila, Kumara, Manu, Prahlada, Bhishma. The Mahajans are there. So, we have to follow Mahajana Jainagadasya Pantha. We should not remain mudhadrisha. We should follow the Mahajan and the Sadhu, Shastra. And they recommend the most important process is Savanam. Chinnatanga Sakata Krishna, Punna Savana Kirtana, If you don't hear about Krishna, then how we'll make advance? We have to hear. My Guru Maharaj was very kind upon me because I was very much interested to hear him. That you know. I did not understand him, actually. In the beginning, I could not understand him. He was speaking in so high philosophical way. It was not, still, I wanted to hear. That was my only qualification. So, it is the process. During lecture time, if we don't care to hear, or we do other things, or take rest, that is not very good sign. We should be very much careful. Then we shall remain mūḍha-drśā, natu-nātya-dharo-yathā. We have taken the vow to see Krishna, to understand Krishna. We should be very, very serious and do the needful. Then our life will be successful. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.